welcome. This is the energy vibration reading for the Sagittarius Sun, Moon, and Rising. I want to say thank you for being here. Thank you for being back. Thank you for the positive situation that has been happening for you Sagittarians. I want to say thank you for your support, your likes and share, and for the support that you has been doing in this month. Now, please listen to your Sun, Moon, and Rising, and welcome all you new Sagittarians. This week is the fourth week of January, and I want to say thank you to each and every person who has supported my channel. It is the week of fire, and the energy vibration is air. The week begins from the 22nd until the 28th. Okay, so here we are, the energy vibration of the Eight of Pentacles. So you'll be working very hard. It's a week of hard working for a lot of people, and this is a wonderful, positive week, because it is a week of hard working. The number 8 seems to be a very prominent energy for this week for you guys. A lot of energy of abundancy is coming in your life. There is the energy vibration of also the 8 of cups. The 8 of cups is a situation where there are a situation that you're leaving behind, and you're moving forward to something that is much better. You have the Ace of Cups. The 8 of Cups is a wonderful, positive beginnings. This is a good start. This is new love that is coming in for you, and this is going to be very positive. As we look at Wednesday, the crowning of your week is the energy of justice. This is a wonderful, positive energy. Whatever the situation, whatever that has transpired, you have the energy of justice, and this is going to be very, very positive. Okay, this is a positive moment that is going to be happening. As we move forward, there is the energy vibration with the 5 of Pentacles. We're going to look, because these pentacles are so big, I don't think like you need to worry over them. Okay, and that's going to be on Thursday. As we move forward, I have the energy vibration of the Ace of Swords. This is another victory and success that is coming in. This is positive. This is using the intellect and information in a proper way to receive this victory and success. And then we have in the weekend, we have the energy of 4 of cups. The energy of the 4 of cups is a situation where you're thinking and you're planning and you're trying to look forward to something different. So you stand there trying to plan your way forward. On Sunday, you have the energy vibration of the Knight of Coins. The Knight of Coins it's the energy vibration of someone between the ages of 25 and 45, and this person is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn. Okay, Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn. So let's go forward and see what is actually advancing in this week. What I'm seeing for the rest of the energy, the energy of the number 8 is always coming up, and it's like walking away and turning your back on something and moving forward. This could be a new love that has come in your life that some people decided to leave behind and move forward. The Ace of Cups is good, because justice is going to come in, and it's going to be a very positive energy, and that's going to be profoundly wonderful, because what is happening is that you have the energy of this new love and justice. You're walking away. The energy of the 5 of Coins, the energy of the 5 of Pentacles is going to be a very, very positive and good. And then we have the 8 of Swords, which is a positive, another Ace of Cups, and the Ace of Swords, which is very good. And you have the 4 of Cups. So whatever that situation is that you are thinking and planning. There is new love coming in with the energy of justice. So it's as if whatever that was injustice and imbalance, new love is going to come in. You know, justice is going to prevail, and new love is going to come in, and you're going to be planning your way forward. As we look at the energy from the Knight of Coins, as I said, it's a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn between the ages of 25 and 45. And there is a situation with justice and this Five of Coin. Okay, so let's go and see what is exactly is transpiring. We have the Four of Cups. So the Four of Cups energy has come up twice. The Four of Cups energy in the first half of the week. Then you have the Queen of Swords, and you're justified against the Queen of Swords. Okay. And justice came in against this Queen of Swords. So this is wonderful. And you know, you need to have balance between you and this person. Okay. So you're thinking and you're planning your way out against this Queen of Swords, and you really need to have temperance and balance. So let's see what is happening here. You have an organy, you have the energy of the Empress, the Emperor, and the energy of the Emperor is that you're leaving a organization, a work behind, a situation where work, people who you have worked with, you're leaving that behind. And you're planning and you're thinking and you're moving forward and you're going to be victorious, okay, by changing your career. Then we have, there's a lot of people turning their backs on things. There is another energy of the Three of Wands, where you're turning your back on the Queen of Swords. You actually turn your back on the Queen of Swords and you're moving forward, okay? Because the energy of the Emperor, you see there is a situation where you're turning your back and you're moving forward. You're looking forward and forward from this Queen of Swords, and you're looking forward and moving forward, okay? And then you have the energy of the Seven of Cups. There's a lot of dreaming and manifestation in this month, this last week. A lot of people are dreaming and wishing and manifesting, and it has to do with justice and the Five of Pentacles. So a lot of people are dreaming and manifesting. So let's see what is going to happen with the Ace, the King of Coins. There seems to be a situation with the energy of the King of Coins. Okay, so we are going to look at the energy of the King of Coins to find out what exactly is happening. And what I'm understanding from this, the Two of Coins and Strength, what I'm understanding from this is obviously that this person is this queen of sword person, because you have turned your back on her, and it's the best thing that you have ever done. Okay, so you could be because you're working hard. It's as if, you know, you're moving forward in your life and you're working very hard in this week and what you've done, because she seems to be the foremost center of the situation, and you have turned your back on her, basically. And she is trying to balance out a situation with the King of Coins. And this person is, she could be seeing this man, because she's dreaming of this man. I think she's dreaming of a better life with this man, that sort of a thing. And you know, it's as if she is the queen, because this is someone over 40, and she is an Aquarius, a Gemini, or a Libra. And you have, you know, like, you have ended this relationship, turn your back on her, and you're moving forward, and which is very good. And but there is a situation that is happening here, because you have you know, victoriously win a situation against the king of coins. And you know, she is thinking, oh, I wish I had, or I wish this had happened differently. And here she's balancing out her financial situation, because you know, the Four of Cups is you planning and trying to see how you can balance out your financial situation. So there is a lot of you know, leaving things behind, because the Eight of Cups is, you know, there are things that you no longer need. The number eight energies, you have 888 that is coming up. Number four. So you have a number four and number eight that is here. So four and eight that is here. To a very wonderful sound. What I need to know is this dreaming about your financial situation. News is coming. Wow, shouldn't do that. I'm sorry. News is coming about. Oh, that's so sweet. Okay, there's news coming in. News coming in from the heart, from I love someone who cares about you. So there is news that is coming in from someone who deeply cares about you. This is a very good friend. So new love is coming in. whatever is happening, it's going to be good. I'm so sorry. My throat. I have really an allergic reaction to carbohydrate things, because once I eat it, my throat just starts scratching and then it's dry. Okay. Love message, flirtation, and new love. Love message, flirtation, and new love will be coming in on Thursday, which is, you know, which is very good. Love message, new message of flirtation is going to be coming in on Thursday, which is very good. I need to know, who is this this king of coins, and what is going on here? I keep on using the wrong hand. Who is this person? Oh, he's a good friend. So it's a good friend, and it's gonna be coming to an end. And we are going to see why is this going to come to an end, because I'm seeing the energy of a good friend, and whatever the situation is, it's going to come to an end. And we are going to be seeing So this is actually good, but what is happening is that number 18 is a significant number for you guys in this week, whatever reason that number came up, you know. And someone, you know, as an accident, friendship ends for some people. So some people, you know, are going to be having an accident. There's no, you know, and some friendships are going to be ending. Friends make a fast, and some of your friends are going to make a very fast decisions. Okay. And then, and that's going to be for this king of this Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. So, you know, there is going to be a fast end to something, and then they're going to be making decisions, okay? And these decisions are emotionally instability. Some people are going to have emotional instability with this Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn person. That is going to happen on Friday. And some people are going to be release of emotions, and some people are going to make emotional decisions. So this is what is transpiring for you, and this is um this this is what is happening. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. It's my son. It's my son. He just wanted to know if he should take over food. Yeah, his mother doesn't cook. I'm sorry. So, So what is happening here is that there is going to be emotional release. People are going to be, and this is someone who is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn, and he's also here. No, well, this is another person who is between the ages of 25 and 45. This is an older person. So, this is what that is going to be happening, but it's okay. It's not to worry. Whatever is happening, you know, just let it be. What I want to know is this queen, what is her problem and what is here? This queen of swords, because she's the center of your reading. It can be, okay. So we have the energy of this queen of sword. This queen of sword has something to do with government or authority, and she is a lady. An argumental lady. Lonely woman. She's a corporate executive. So for some people, this queen of sword, who is an Aquarians, a Gemini, or a Libra, it is someone from a government organization, a protection or authority, and she is very argumental. That is going to affect some people. And for some people, she's a lonely woman, and for some people, it's a corporate executive. Okay, and this has to do with because you know, this is the center of this woman, and it has to do with a beginning, a woman and child, young looking and immature. So a woman and child is, you know, and this has to do with an government or authority and that sort of a thing. But I'm thinking that it has to do with a new start for you. So whatever this situation, whatever that has transpired. So, you know, it is this woman, that woman in that government organization, it has to do with you and a new start and that sort of a thing. It could be someone who is in corporate, okay? Not to worry about this, whoever this woman is, it's going to be working out okay. All right. That was the underline that really asked me. So let's look at what the light workers wants to tell the Sagittarians. What does the light worker wants to tell the Sagittarians? Spiritual service. So this is good. Whatever is happening, the energy of spiritual service is here, and it's the number 21. I love number 21 because it's three, it's the world. It's one of those very nice number. It's three and it's the world, whatever way, whether it's 12 or number 21. Okay, so the invocation, universe, I love you. How can I serve you? I accept love, protects and love purpose in my heart, in my life. Love empowers and protects me. Give me purpose and passion, peace and play. I believe in love. I am love, and I believe in me. May the joy of helping others give me energy and courage to communicate, to serve, and grow spirits. May all beings receive your love and be and through your grace. May all those who wants to serve be empowered through mercies, compassion, joy, and love to do so for the greatest good. Though through my own free will, so be it. Through my own free will, so be it. So this is a very, very, very wonderful message. So let's go forward and let's see what is happening here for ask a question, what question you would like to be answered. So ask a question, what question you'd like to be answered. Trust in the universe that things are going to be working out. You need to have more trust in yourself and the universe that things are going to be working out. And I want to say namaste until next week.